Here we go.
Okay, ready?
We're ready.
Hi, I'm Gil. This is the FlyBase workshop. Thank you everyone for coming. We've got 1 hour. I'll start things off by spending about 15 minutes to review what's new at FlyBase, and then we'll open it up to questions. Please feel free to ask about the presentation itself or really anything that you might want to know about FlyBase. If possible, we ask that you submit your questions using Slido. You can follow the link in the Zoom chat, or you can go to slido.com and type in the code FlyBase. Okay, let's jump right in. The FlyBase updates that we want to highlight cover a broad range of aspects. They generally fall into one of two categories. The first category we have are new features that help you deal with the ever-increasing amount of information at FlyBase, by either providing tools that help you find reagents of interest or by providing visualizations that integrators summarize the data to provide a better view of the big picture. In the second category, we have improvements to things that are more familiar, like JBrowse, ID validator, fast track your paper, and sequence ontology data. So we'll go through this list one by one and describe each update in a bit more detail today. I'll start with the new responsive tables. We've started to implement interactive tables at FlyBase, starting with things like alleles and transgenes. And these tables allow you to filter, sort, and rearrange tabular data, which is especially helpful as the amount of information increases. As an example, I'm showing the responsive allele table on the breathless gene report. For each column, there's a little search box. Clicking on a header allows you to sort the rows by values in that column. And at the top right, there's also an option to add or hide columns so you can customize your data. So for example, if you click on the inserted element type column header, you can sort the rows by those values and quickly get a sense for the content in that column. You can also search each column and the table will start filtering as you type. In this example, I've just started typing M cherry and I can quickly see that there's one allele. We've also implemented these responsive tables for our Gal4 etc. search tool. This tool is available right on the FlyBase homepage. It lets you search for drivers based on either expression pattern or gene. You can also just browse the most frequently used Gal4 drivers in the table. I'll note that the search by gene is a recent improvement. So what we've done for this tool is implement the responsive tables for looking at the search results. In my example here, a search for neuron with this tool returns thousands of results. With the responsive tables, you can start to whittle that down quite easily. For example, typing Lexe into the encoded toolbox narrows down the list quite a bit. You can further filter those results based on an anatomical term or regulatory region, et cetera. So we hope that these interactive tables make it easy for you to sift through all the information that we have available. Next up, we have the new pathway reports, which represent a new curated resource at FlyBase. The idea is to facilitate access to data on signaling pathways. Right now we have data on 16 pathways. These reports are organized in a hierarchical way. Apologies. With a top level report and subreports that cover the core set of components required for the activated pathway to function, as well as subgroups represented positive and negative regulators of the core components. Sometimes we even have more subgroups, like for the Wnt TCF pathway shown here, we have another subgroup for factors involved in Wnt ligand production. At the top of the reports, you'll see high level summaries. There's also a listing of the subgroups. In addition to that, there's a cytoscape network diagram integrating curated pathway components with FlyBase curated physical interaction data. Genes in the diagram can either be colored by their subgroup or by their functional annotations as shown here, for example, ligand, receptor, et cetera. The size of each gene in the diagram reflects the number of supporting papers, capped at 10. Pathway members of any given grouping can also be viewed in responsive tables, which I've already described. These tables can be filtered and sorted, and they can be exported to FlyBase ortholog and batch download tools. If you're interested, you can search for these reports using the Pathways quick search tool. There's also an option to just browse our reports from there, or you can find the links on our gene reports. Okay, on to disease model data at FlyBase. I want to highlight two improvements here. First, we now annotate fly genes predicted to be relevant to human disease via their orthology to human disease associated genes. There are about 4,800 of these annotations. You can find them on gene reports or get them all in one bulk file. Second, we have what we call ribbons that summarize disease model data. So for example, there are ribbons for four sets of high-level disease ontology terms like infection, proliferation, affected anatomical entity, and other disease types. The color of each box represents the number of annotations that fall into each of those categories. If you hover over a box, you can see the list of specific disease annotations for that term. And I'll just point out that the number of annotations includes both experimental and predicted annotations. All right, now I'll tell you about updates to the sequence ontology at FlyBase. The sequence ontology is a set of controlled vocabulary terms used by many biological databases to annotate and classify genomic features like genes and sequence variants. For example, on a FlyBase gene report, there's a section containing a gene sequence ontology annotations. And at the top of the gene report, the primary sequence ontology annotation for the gene is shown as the feature type. So we've recently updated the version of the sequence ontology that we're using. Now at FlyBase, we update other ontologies all the time, like our fly anatomy or Go ontologies. Normally that's not something that we really highlight to the community. So what's so special about this sequence ontology update? Well, it's special because we've gone about 15 years without an update here, owing to the vast and deeply embedded technical dependencies related to this ontology. So this is a big update for this type of data that should be quite noticeable to our users. This update makes our data more compatible with third-party exports and applications that use sequence ontology annotations. And perhaps more relevant to the typical FlyBase user, the update provides a much richer set of terms that we can use to improve our annotation of genomic features in a structured way. And when I say structured, that essentially means that the annotations are now much easier to search and browse at FlyBase. We can illustrate this point by comparing a gene report before and after the sequence ontology update. Looking at an old gene report for the ROX1 link RNA, you can see how our annotation options were limited before the update. We had to use the generic term like non-protein coding gene, and we had to use free text to add specificity. In this case, a comment saying that the gene encoded a link RNA. And while the gist may have been clear on a given gene report, it wasn't so easy to search for that data or to find other genes sharing those characteristics. With a sequence ontology update, we can now use more specific annotations. In this case, we're using the term link RNA gene and getting rid of the more generic term and the related comment. Not only is this a bit cleaner on the gene report here, but you can also click on one of these annotations to find other genes that share that annotation. So if you click on one of these terms like link RNA gene, this brings you to a CV or controlled vocabulary term report in our vocabularies tool. From there, you can find other genes sharing that annotation or browse the ontologies for related terms in annotation. You can also access our vocabularies tool right from the homepage if you want to jump right into browsing our sequence ontology annotations. And on the right of the slide, I'm just showing you a comparison of our gene class sequence ontology terms before and after the update. And you can see on the right how it's much richer now. Okay, we're heading into the home stretch of this talk. I'm going to go over the last three items a little bit more quickly. First, JBrowse, which is now the standard genome browser at FlyBase. JBrowse supplants GBrowse, which will be phased out over the next year. JBrowse offers many advantages, including faster performance, better scaling of large data sets, new data visualization features, and improved options for searching and browsing available data tracks. We've also reorganized the data tracks on the left here into a hierarchical tree with more intuitive section headings. And with track descriptions, that are readily accessible from the question mark icon here in the track view. New data tracks include FlyAtlas 2 RNA-seq genome coverage tracks, which include lots of male and female samples for studies of sexual dimorphism, and a polyadenylation sites track that offers a view of alternative transcript polyadenylation. Next up is our ID validator, formerly ID converter. And for anyone that has a list of FlyBase features and wishes to perform a batch query or download, this tool provides a useful starting point. It cleans up that list of features to make sure that downstream steps run more smoothly. The ID validator updates FlyBase symbols and IDs where necessary or possible. It also converts certain external IDs like GenBank, UniProt, and PubMed IDs into their FlyBase equivalents. The output of this tool is a validation table that can be downloaded as a file or exported to various FlyBase tools. And the last item on our list is the Fast Track Your Paper tool. First introduced over 10 years ago, this tool allows authors to provide first pass curation of their papers. This results in relevant genes being associated with the paper right away, and so that paper is listed on those gene reports right away. This tool also indicates to curators data types in the paper, streamlining our curation process and accelerating incorporation of that data into FlyBase. Key improvements include warnings to authors if a paper has already been curated by FlyBase, so to avoid duplicate effort, an easier to use gene search tool, some pre-populated information to speed up the process for authors, and new data types, including chemical cell lines, pathways, large data sets, and technical advances. For the technical advances, we now have a wiki page to highlight them. So we hope, we thank all authors for using this tool, and we hope that these improvements make it a smoother process. Now, before I wrap up, I just want to point out how you can stay in touch with FlyBase. Near the top of every FlyBase page, we have a blue navigation bar. Under community, you can find links to our Twitter account or sign up for our newsletter. Under about, you can find FlyBase presentations, including this one. Under help, you can get a contact form, and so you can email us with your questions or feedback. We also have links to the contact form, YouTube, and Twitter at the bottom of every FlyBase page. So please don't hesitate to ask us questions or provide feedback. And I really want to put in a plug for our Twitter account. With each FlyBase release, our resident tweeter, Sean Grammatis, puts out really in-depth descriptions of new features, something that Sean likes to call tweetorials. So Twitter is a great way to stay up to date with FlyBase updates. And these tweetorials are searchable using the hashtag FlyBase tweetorial hashtag. Okay, that's just about it. We'd like to thank first and foremost the Drosophila community for their continued support, everyone that joined us at the talk today. Of course, thanks to our granting agencies, the NHGRI, MRC, and NSF. We're also a part of the Alliance of Genome Resources Consortium, a collaboration between FlyBase and various other model organism databases from which we get additional funding. And thanks to the FlyBase team, particularly Aoife, Arzu, and Victoria for helping with this presentation, and Julie for setting up the question for it. And finally, I'll end with one final plug for FlyBase posters here at DROS21. Helen is presenting a poster about understanding gene function, and Stephen is presenting a poster about enzyme catalog for Drosophila. Thanks for listening. Now let's see if we have any questions.
Thank you, Gil.